Good morning, children. Today we are performing an experiment number 1 of our subject physics, which is the aim of the experiment is to measure the diameter of a given wire and thickness of a given sheet using a screw gauge. Now you better know what do you mean by a screw gauge. So screw gauge is one of the instrument which is used to find out the thickness of any of a thin object as well as to find out the diameter of any of a thin object. So here in this experiment, we are going to find out the diameter of the given wire as well as the thickness of the given sheet. Now the material required for this experiment is a screw gauge, a thin wire and a paper sheet. So this is what the screw gauge and the thin wire. Here, this is what the thin wire to which by using a screw gauge you are going to find out the diameter of this thin wire. As well as you can take any of a sheet of a paper, you can take A4 size any sheet of a paper to which you can find out the thickness of the paper. Okay? But before that, you must know what do you mean by the least count. Now to any of a small device, small instrument, it is having we have to find out the least count of that small instrument. Okay? Now how to find out the least count? Now the least count, the formula for the least count is pitch. Pitch means what? A smallest distance. Pitch means a smallest distance that we can measure between the two lines. Okay? Which is the horizontal distance. It is also known as the number of smallest division on main scale divided by total number of division on a circular scale. Now, in the screw gauge, there are two scales. See, there are two scales. This is a circular scale. And here if you see, here, it is the main scale. It is the main scale. Look. So, this one is the main scale. It starts from zero. And after zero, there are number of lines. Okay, there are number of lines. In between 0 and 5, there are 4 lines. See, in between 0 and 5, there are 4 lines. So, if suppose that okay, this is our main scale, it starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is what? 5. This is what? 5. Now, your main scale, it is given in millimeter. Okay, the screw gauge is of millimeter. What is the unit? It is millimeter. So, if the main scale is measured in millimeter, now how will you find out the smallest division on the main scale? So, see, this is 0 and after 4 line, there is a reading which is given over here. It is 5. It is 5. Right? So 0 to 5 and in between 0 to 5, there are 4 lines. If you find out the distance between these two lines, because if this is 5, that means it is 1 millimeter. It is 2 millimeter, this is 3 millimeter, and if we take the difference between these two lines, in between 1 and 0, it takes only 1 millimeter. It is only 1 millimeter, okay? So the smallest division on the main scale, it is what? 1 millimeter. Okay? So I write down here 0.1 millimeter. In centimeter we can write down it as 0.1. So it is 1 millimeter is the number of smallest division on main scale. And now we will divide it with total number of division on circular scale. Now see, this one is a main scale. And this is what the circular scale. If I rotate this, this is what the circular scale. So here some readings are, some numbers are written over here. Again there is one 0. Okay, I'll show you closer. In the next part, I'll show it very closer to you. See, this is one the 0. And here it is 10, 20. So in between 0 to 10, there are number of lines. Right? So this is what the circular scale. If I rotate this, this is what the circular scale. So there are as such, there are 100 number of lines over here. In between 0 to 10, there are 10 number of lines. In between 10 to 20, again there are 10 number of lines. So the complete circular scale is having 100 division. So and that circular scale is, it is not in will count it as division. So I'll write down here 100 division. Okay. Now 1 upon 100, it will give 0.01 millimeter. So what is the least count of screw gauge? It is 0.01 millimeter. Or in terms of centimeter, it will be equal to 0.001 centimeter. So okay. So in the first part, we find out the least count 0.01 millimeter. Okay, by using the formula pitch. Pitch is the smallest pitch distance between the two lines which should be measured horizontally. That is also known as the number of smallest division on main scale, where this one is the main scale and here there is a circular scale. Okay, and divided it with the total number of division on circular scale. So pitch that we get of this screw gauge is what? 1 millimeter, because in between the 0 and 5 there are 4 lines. So that if we take a difference between the starting two lines, so it will give 1 millimeter. So 1 millimeter is the number of smallest division on main scale and total number of division on circular scales are 100. So student, these are what the, this is what the circular scale and some numbers are there. It starts from 0, it ends at 100. Okay, so 1 by 100, so it will be giving 0.01 millimeter is the least count of the screw gauge. Right. One more thing I want to add here, because if you just close this, if you just close by using this circular one scale, see, so the zero of the circular scale, it coincides with the zero of the main scale. The zero of the circular scale, it coincides with the zero of the main scale. Now, if this condition is happening in any of a device, like in screw gauge, if both the zero they are coinciding one, it means that this is not having any zero error. It is not having any zero error. Why? Because the zero of the circular scale, it is coinciding with the zero of the main scale. So it proved that, it shows that with this instrument, it doesn't have any zero, it doesn't have any zero error. Okay, so no error is in this device, right? Now we'll do the practical. Okay, because we have to find out the thickness of the sheet as well as the diameter of the wire. So now let's do the practical.
Now we have taken a thin wire and we'll find out the diameter of this wire. Okay, now the observation table says that we have to take the diameter along horizontal direction as well as vertical, that means perpendicular direction. Okay, so if I keep this wire as along horizontal direction first, see, if I rotate this circular scale, now we'll check what is the MSR. MSR means the main scale. See, this is the main scale. So it is 1 mm, it is 1 millimeter, and this 40 of circular scale, it is coincide with the zero of the main scale, right? So that means we'll write down that MSR is 1 mm and CSD, this is what the division, a circular scale is in division first, okay? So it is 40, it is 40. Now what is CSR? CSR is to convert. CSR means we'll multiply this CSD with least count. Now we have already find out the least count and the least count is 0.01. So this 40 into 0.01, it will give 0.40 mm. Now total reading means what? MSR plus CSR. So this is what? 1 plus 0.40. So it will give 1.40. This is mm. Okay. In the same way, we can find out at 2 or 3 position along horizontal direction. So again, I'll place here. This is horizontal direction. If I rotate this close, again, if you see the MSR doesn't change. The MSR doesn't change, but yes, now the value of this CSR is different. Okay, now it is about 40 it is 48. So I'll write down 1 mm as the MSR and 48 as the CSD, so that after multiplying this CSD 48 into the least count 0.01, it will be 0.48. okay, so that now the total reading MSR plus CSR is 1.48. So there are only little difference. Similarly, in the next position, if I find out, okay, with the horizontal one anywhere, so again if you check, so here it is 1 mm is like 1 mm is there, and it is nearly, see, again it is what, 38. So this is 38 and 1 mm. So it will give 38 multiplied by 0.01, which is equal to 0.38 mm. So that total reading will be 1.38. So this is what the horizontal direction. If I take a perpendicular direction, so I have to keep like this. This I have to keep a wire like this. Again, if I rotate and if I close by keeping it in a vertical direction, perpendicular direction, like this, I'll take only one reading for it, like this. So see, now again, if you see here, zero is coinciding with what? Zero is coinciding with nearly 34. So I'll write down 1 mm is the MSR, CSD is what, 34, and here CSR will be multiplication of 34 with the least count, so that it is 0.34. and MSR plus CSR means 1.34. Okay? Similarly, at the different position, if we take, so again a perpendicular one, if I keep like this, so no, it is not. So see, again it is nearly 40. So it is 1 mm, and this is 40. So again it is 1.40, and this will be 0.40, and this is 1.40. And in the same way, if we find out at another position like this, so see, this is somewhat 35. So this is 35, and again it is 1 mm. So this is 0.35 and this is 1.35. Okay. Now here the total D, the diameter will be equals to D1 plus D2. Now here this total reading is D1 and this total reading is D2. We add these two and divide with 2. Similarly, 1.48 plus 1.40 divided by 2, and 1.38 plus 1.35 divided by 2. If we calculate, so you will be getting 2.74 divided by 2. So this will give 1.37 mm. So this 1.37 mm is the diameter of the wire. Similarly, 1.48 plus 1.40 is 2.88. divided by 2. So this will give 1.44 mm as the diameter. And similarly, this it will give 1.38 and 1.35. So it is 2.73 divided by 2. It will give 1.361 millimeter. And now we'll find out the mean, and mean diameter is equals. So the mean diameter, we'll find out the mean by addition of all three. So 1.37 plus 1.44 plus 1.36 divided with 3. So this will give now 6, 10 and 7, 17. So the mean is, after addition of all these three readings and divided by 3, we get 1.39 mm. So this 1.39 mm is the diameter of the wire. Okay, it is the diameter of the wire. Now the next part is to find out the thickness of thin sheet. We'll take any of the thin sheet and we'll find out the thickness of the thin sheet. Okay. So suppose I have taken this as the thin sheet. I'll find out the thickness of the thin sheet by using a screw gauge again. Okay. That means MSR and CSR. So I'll keep here like this. Then close. Don't press. So it is Now if you see here again, it is very much pressed. Okay, so this is what, near about 1 mm. And if you find out the value of CSD, MSR is 1 mm, but if you find out the value of a CSD, so it is near about 75. Okay. So the first reading I'll be writing as MSR is 1 mm because it is very thin, and CSD is 70. Okay. CSR will be again CSD multiplied by the least count. So 70 multiplied by 0.01, it will give 0.70. Total reading, that means the thickness. Thickness of that paper, it is 1.70 mm because we have to add MSR plus CSR. Similarly, at different position, if I take, okay, if I change the position of the paper here, and if I take here again, so if you see, again the zero is here, huh? So this is 1 mm along with the CSR is now, CSD is nearly 60. So this I'll put 60 here, and this is 1 mm. This is the second reading. You'll be getting 0.60 and it is 1.60 mm. Similarly, at the third position, if I take, so I'll just place over the next three readings. Here also, if you see, it is 1 mm nearly, but the CSD is, CSD is somewhat, no, it is just, it is again, I'll write down 59, and this is 1 millimeter, the third reading. So it is 0.59 and it will give 1.59 mm. Okay. So we'll find out the mean thickness. thickness of a thin sheet. Mean. So how will you find out the mean? So you have to add all this 1.70 mm plus 1.60 plus 1.59 and divide it with 3. So it will be 9, 6, 5, 11, and this is 4.89 divided by 3, 3.63. So 1.63 mm is the thickness of the thin paper. So in this way you have to perform the both part in this experiment, okay, and then you have to write down the result.